गुड आफ्टरनून, वेलकम टू डीसीबी सूर्यापेटा यूट्यूब चैनल खम्मम एंड सूर्यापेटा डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स। नाइन्थ क्लास ऑनलाइन क्लासेस सोशल स्टडीज इंग्लिश मीडियम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ 14th लेसन सोशल प्रोटेस्ट मूवमेंट्स। इन रियर क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड पार्ट वन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न पार्ट टू। दिस इज वड्डे चंद्रशेखर, school assistant, social studies, working at GHS EPS Madira. In the part one, we have discussed about consequences of industrialization and how the industrialization changes the lives of people in different ways. We have discussed, and we have discussed about the French nationalistic ideas like freedom, equality, fraternity, like this we have discussed, and how these nationalistic ideas inspired the people, and in different ways we have discussed and we have learnt. And people, they started studying different subjects like economics, poetry, arts, culture, like that we have discussed in the first part. And also discussed about Luddism, Luddism, which is proposed by General Ned Ludd, and what are the principles of Luddism also we have discussed. So today we are going to learn another class, another part from the this lesson. In this lesson we are going to we are going to learn about the socialism. So the student explains about the socialism from today's class. The student explains about Marx and Engels ideology. So by listening our class, Marx and Engels ideology also he can explain. The student explains the definition of the feminism. The student explains that why women protested in the society and what are the demands of women. The student gives names of Indian who influenced by socialism. So the student gives the names of Indians who influenced by socialism. So first, what is socialism? Today, in today's class, we are going to learn about socialism and the principle, main principles of socialism. So in earlier class, we have discussed about Luddism. Luddism is against to the machines, and they demanded for working job for the people who lost jobs due to mechanism or machines. But this Luddism was suppressed by the government and army because they demanded against the government. That's why they suppressed. A new ideology, socialism, developed slowly in the European countries. So socialism means it calls for public ownership rather than private control of property and natural resources. Socialism calls for public ownership rather than private control of property and natural resources. So socialism gives importance to the private public ownership on natural resources. When public has ownership on natural resources, they can distribute the natural resources equally, and overcome the inequality, economic inequalities also. That's why socialism tells for public ownership. Individuals do not live or work in isolation, but live in cooperation with one another. So another principle in socialism is individuals do not live or work in isolation, but live in cooperation with one another. So this is also another principle of socialism. So here you are seeing two pictures of main socialist ideologists like Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. These are the two people who influenced the society very much with their writings. So everything that people produce is a social property and they have right to use it. So in socialism, another principle is everything that people produce is a social property and they have right to use it. So all products, everyone anyone can use the products which are produced by the society, and everyone has right to use them. There is no private ownership of the products. At the same time, socialism opposed to the basic idea of capitalism. So capitalism contradictory to the socialism. So socialism gives importance for the public ownership on natural resources, but capitalism gives importance to the private property, and it cannot accept the public ownership on natural resources. That's why socialism is opposed to the basic idea of capitalism. Socialists complain that capitalism distributes wealth and power in an unfair and unexploitative manner. The main argument of socialism on capitalism is capitalism distributes the wealth and power in an unfair manner between some persons only. It cannot distribute the wealth equally to the all people. Just the people who have more talent or more influence, they can only earn more money and they can concentrate the money at one place. That's why socialists oppose capitalism. The rich then use their wealth and power to increase their dominance in the society. In the capitalistic society, the rich people who are having more money, they can influence and they can dominate the society with their wealth and power. So that's why it is not it is opposed by the socialism. So here is a pyramid of capitalist society or system. So you can observe the top money is there. So some of the people only enjoying money, but for enjoyment of the rich people, so many lakhs of people, common people, working for the enjoyment of the rich people. So you can observe in the downside, so many people are working for the enjoyment of the rich people. In the upper stages, you can see the pictures of the rich people. So in the capitalist society, the wealth of so many lakhs of people grabbed by the rich and influenced people. That's why socialism is against the capitalism. So in the capitalism, their choices in turn limit the options of the poor. So the rich people and the influenced people, they enjoy all the resources in the society. Because of the enjoyment of the rich people, that limits the options of the poor people. Next, in socialist view, true freedom and true equality means that society should control the resources that provide the basis for prosperity in any society. So the main importance or view of socialistic view towards true freedom and true equality is control the resources by society that provide the basis for prosperity in any society. So socialism tells that when we have control, public control on resources only, the society will develop. Then this is the socialistic view towards the true freedom and true equality. Socialists believe that because the resources are distributed unequally in the capitalism. Okay, socialism believes that the resources are distributed unequally. So that's why the rich people manage to move the balance in their favor by hook or crook. So the rich people are who have more money or influenced people. They manage the things in the society by using their wealth, by using their power, either hook or crook. They can use anything to manage people or manage things. Some socialist thinkers like Plato and Thomas More, they gave importance to the socialism and they give importance to the public ownership rather than the private ownership. So another thinker, a socialist thinker, Babeck, he argued that in order to get complete equality, private property and common enjoyment of the people and its fruits should be abolished. So to get complete equality, we should abolish first private property and common enjoyment of the land. So, and its fruit should be abolished. So if we abolish public property, And public ownership on natural resources, we can get complete equality in the society. This is the argument of Bhavel. For this argument, he was executed by the government. Okay, next, another socialist thinker, Saint Simon of France, said that public control of property through central planning. So in socialism, we are telling that public ownership is important. For public ownership, we should have some central planning at national level or central level. Whenever we have plan, we can manage resources properly. If we can manage resources properly, we can develop easily and we can distribute the wealth equally among the people in the society. So that's why Saint Simon of France said that we should have central planning for public control of property. Another, England is the home of Industrial Revolution. So the Industrial Revolution started firstly in England, in Europe. That's why England treated as home of Industrial Revolution. Industrial Revolution changed the lives of people in so many ways. The way of work also changed, the way of living also changed, the way of relationship also changed. So in so many ways, the industrialization changed the lives of the people. At the same time, industrialization create some social classes in the society like capitalistic group, working class, and middle class. These are the three important classes which were emerging because of the industrialization. So in these three classes, in capitalistic class, they enjoyed all the properties and all the profits. And working class, they didn't have any minimum facilities also. Another small industrialist, Owen, was disturbed by the conditions of the workers and the wealth of the capitalists. So that's why he took an initiative for building cooperative villages. So this is a new concept which was proposed by a small industrialist, Owen, that is building of cooperative villages. In the cooperative villages, all people, they should cooperate each other and they develop for themselves. So then automatically that village develop in a cooperative manner. That's why he proposed this cooperative villages concept. So here, children, you are observing two pictures. First picture is a picture of Babeb and the second picture of Saint Simon. So these are the two personalities, socialist thinkers who worked for the socialism. So next, Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. Now only we have seen the pictures of Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels, and these two people, they developed a concept of socialism, and they argued that capitalism is both a progressive as well as an exploitative system. So they agreed that capitalism is a progressive one, but at the same time it is an exploitative system. So how we will see how capitalism is a progressive way. Capitalism helpful for the industrial transformation, and because of the industries, it can fulfill everyone's necessities. So because of the Industrial Revolution only, now we are enjoying with the goods which are produced in industries to fulfill our basic needs and necessities. This is the positive side of capitalism. Capitalism helpful for the industrial transformation. But it has a negative side, that is, it forces the working classes to lives of extreme hard work and difficulties. So in the capitalism, the capitalists or industrialists, they have all rights on production and production process. The workers, just they have work based on wages, and there is no involvement of workers in the production process and the production-related decisions. Just all the decisions taken by the industries, but the workers, just they have to follow the rules and regulations of the industry, and they have to work under the supervision of cruel foremen and supervisors. So that's why always the capitalists or industrialists, they try to grab the hard work of the labor or workers, and they pay just less salaries for more work. And they insist the workers to work more hours for less salaries. So that's why the workers faced so many difficulties and without they lived in the places where there are no minimum facilities also, like drinking water, sanitation, hospital facilities and education facilities. So like this, in capitalism forces the working classes to lives of extreme hard work and difficulties. Thus, production had become an all-society affair rather than a matter of one family or a small farm or one village. So in the socialism, production process is a matter of society, not one family or small farm or one village like capitalism. So these are the ideas of Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. Next, Marx and Engels argued that workers had no property right, most important for the production to happen. So in the capitalism, the workers, they didn't have any property right and they didn't have any right to take decisions related to the production process. But they have to work only on the basis of instructions given by the industrialists. But the Marx and Engels, they argued about management should be given to the workers to run the factories. If the workers run the factories for common benefit, a new and equitable society could be established. Marx and Engels, they argued to give management to the workers. They said that if the workers run the factories for common benefit, a new and equitable society could be established. Workers should take over the state government and all factories and land. So Marx and Engels said that one more important point is all land and factories should be taken by the workers to control them. So why they gave importance to the workers to control all land and factories? So if control of land and factories within the hands of workers, they can manage wealth and property on the basis of equality and equally. That's why they gave importance to the workers. Marx and Engels made a great impact on radical thinkers. Radical thinkers who opposed with the Marx and Engels, they always argue with the Marx and support a new ideology. The persons who disagreed with Marx and developed a new theory like anarchism. So anarchism is a belief of the people who doesn't want any restrictions in the society. So they want to abolish all the governments and organizations of society and voluntarily cooperative without any restrictions or force, just is a voluntary activity. And anarchists, they don't want any governments or organizations to control, just they want leave the people independently and freely. That is a principle of anarchism. So in 1917, Russia faced a revolution, Russian Communist Revolution. So because of the Russian Communist Revolution, so many world personalities, famous personalities influenced by the socialistic principles. Like our Swami Vivekananda, influenced by socialism when he traveled to Europe and America. And it supports many leaders like M.N. Roy, Bhagat Singh, Jawaharlal Nehru, etc. These people also inspired by socialism. As factory production developed in India, many leaders organized trade unions who influenced by the socialism. So some of the Indians, some of the Indian great personalities who influenced by socialism, they formed trade unions when factory production developed in India. Leaders were influenced by the Marxism and went on to found the Communist Party of India in the 1920s in India. That is, Communist Party of India, commonly known as CPI, was established by the leaders who influenced by the Marxism. So, children, you are observing the pictures of two great personalities of India. Can you guess the names of these personalities? Yes, Swami Vivekananda and Bhagat Singh. These are the two great personalities who influenced by socialism. Next, women's movement. Why women protested and they started movements? What are the demands of women? Women did not have access to property or civil rights like voting. So in the earlier days, women didn't give any right to vote or right to property or right to participation. That's why they protested for these rights. Mostly restricted to domestic work like cooking, bringing up children, taking care of the elderly at home, assisting men at work. So women restricted to the only home, household purpose only, and household, they engaged in household activities only. They didn't allow to outside to participate in the political or cultural or traditional activities in the outside. This started to change with industrialization as women began to be employed in factories. So when industrialization started, women also, they engaged in factories. When they engaged or employed in factories, they realized about their discrimination in the society and they realized about what they want to live freely and equally along with the men in the society. They began to assert the principle of equality of all human beings. So when they engaged in industries, they came to know the importance of equality in the society. So when French revolutionaries were preparing the Declaration of Rights of Men in 1791, women demanded for separate declaration of the rights of women. So they demanded for the separate declaration of rights of women. So this is a initiation of women's protest. Declaration of the rights of women declared women are born free, remain equal to men in all rights. So Declaration of the Rights of Women declared that women are born free along with the men and they have equality and they have equal rights along with men. And employment should be given based on talents and not on the basis of gender. But this declaration declared that women have all rights, but this declaration never passed by French Assembly. And the goal, the important goals of women's movement in America and Europe were that the demands of women are equal treatment with men and right to participation, right to vote, and the demand for holding of public posts. These are the four important demands of women and women protests. So first one is the equal treatment with men. So up to then, they treated as second class citizen in the society after men. And they demanded for right to participate in all cultural activities, traditional activities, and political activities. And they demanded for right to vote. And they demanded for holding of public posts along with the men. And they don't want any discrimination taking of different types of employment. Women came out in large numbers demanding the right to vote called as women suffragists. Okay, women suffragists means the women came out in large numbers demanding the right to vote called as women suffragists. Russian Revolution was the first to grant such rights to all women in 1917. So Russian Revolution gave all rights to the women after Russian Communist Revolution, which was happened in 1917. Next, right to vote extended for some women in England in 1918. So in 1918, England gave right to vote to for only few women, not to all, but it extends to all adult women by 1928. So in 1928, all women who are living in England, they got a right to vote. Okay. So as women participated more and more in public matters, they realized that women were treated unequally and dominated by men. So when women started participating in public matters, they realized that they were treated unequally and they were dominated by men. So they came to know that we should have equality and we should have equal rights. For to inspire the people or women, Virginia Woolf, a woman writer, wrote about how men dominate over women. So based on the writings of Virginia Woolf, so many women inspired and they participated in the women protest movements. So writing is also useful for the inspiration. After Second World War, a new phase started in women's movement, and it was focused on gaining equality. So after Second World War, which was ended in 1945, so a new phase started in women's movement, and that movement focused on gaining equality. So they have given importance to the equality. So if we have equality, we can enjoy all other rights also. Campaigned against cultural and political inequalities. Up to then, the women treated inequally in cultural aspects and political aspects. So they campaigned against them also. They understood power distributed unequally. The women, they came to know and they understood power distributed unequally between men and women. Then they demanded for equal power, equal distribution of power between all people. First wave feminism focused on absolute rights such as suffrage. So first the women, they demanded for suffrage. Suffrage means right to vote. If we have right to vote, we can elect the people who we like. So who gave more importance to the women than the men? So that is the first right to vote. The second wave feminism focused on other aspects of equality, such as end to discrimination in all aspects of life. So the second wave, in the second wave, the feminism focused on other aspects like equality. If we have equality, we can end up all discriminations in all aspects of life, like cultural inequality, political inequality, and domestic inequality. Like that, we can end up all inequalities if we have right to equality. So feminism focused on first in suffrage and second on aspects of equality. So which will helpful to get more equality in the society. So here, children, you are observing the picture of Virginia Woolf, woman writer who inspired the woman with the writings. Okay, she is Virginia Woolf. So Indian context. So up to now, we have discussed about the worldly concerns and worldly aspects. Now we are going to discuss about Indian aspect or Indian context. Up to 19th century, India to end up all practices like sati practice, killing of girl child at birth. So in India, we are giving importance to the male child than the girl child. That's why so many families, they kill when they born, they gave born to girl child. So that is also one of the superstitious belief. And another practice is sati practice. This is also one of the superstitious belief. So at the same time, enforced widowhood for life and enforced widowhood. So this is also one of the superstitious belief. So for these three types of superstitious beliefs, we end up to 19th century. So in the 19th century, and also to extend modern education to women. So in 19th century, we have given access to the women to educate or to get modern education. So women, when they educated, they can realize about their rights and their place in the society, whether they are discriminating or not, they can understand easily. So for that, at the time of national movement, our famous national leader and father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi, specially emphasized the importance of women, and so many women national leaders, they participated in the national movement, and so many women, they sacrificed their life, they sacrificed their ornaments, they sacrificed their time, and they participated in the national movement along with the male. So Mahatma Gandhi gave special importance to the women participation in the national movement also. Okay, thousands of women joined in the national movement, like Durgabai Deshmukh. So many women, Aruna Asaf Ali, so many women leaders are there who participated and inspired other women to get equality in the society. When India became independent, women were given complete legal equality, vice versa, men. So in 1947, India became independent. So when India became independent in 1950, Constitution of India came into force. When the Constitution of India came into force, Constitution gave importance to complete legal equality to women, all the people, and it abolished all types of discrimination in the society. Okay, so when India became independent, women were given complete legal equality along with the men, and right to vote also, right to participation, right to participate in all matters like cultural and political. So they got all types of equal rights along with the men. That is the greatness of our Indian Constitution. So this is about Indian context. So here you can, children, you are seeing the picture of Mahatma Gandhi. So he is a leader of our Indian national movement. So now we have discussed so many aspects up to now. Once again, I will recapitulate the lesson briefly. So first, in our class today, we have discussed about socialism. Socialism is a new ideology. It calls for public ownership on resources rather than the private ownership. And always socialism gives importance to the public ownership and equal distribution of wealth and natural resources. But whereas capitalism gives importance to the private ownership rather than the public ownership, and capitalism allows the people to earn more profit and they can enjoy their profit. So that's why socialism opposed capitalism. Socialism coined by Karl Marx and Engels, and they explained clearly about the principles of socialism, and they gave importance to the workers to maintain all land and factories, and then only equitable society should be established when workers got independence and when they have managed the factories and lands. So that's why Karl Marx and Engels gave importance to the workers, and participation of workers should be more in the factory and production process. So women protested against discrimination. So when women participated, employed in industries after industrialization, they came to know what are the inequalities are there, and how they are discriminating in the society, and how they are treated as second-class citizen. So they came to know about the discrimination, and they started demanding for equality. So then the women protest movements were started. For that, to inspire the women, Virginia Woolf, like so many women writers, also inspired the women with their writings. So many socialist thinkers argued for the abolition of private ownership. So this is a fundamental principle of socialism, is abolition of private ownership. In India, India gave all rights to women when it became independent in 1947. When our Indian Constitution came into force in 1950, we have given all rights to women. So this is about the lesson. So now, these are the questions for evaluation purpose. So children, try to write the answers to these questions and show it to your social studies teacher in your school. First question is, define socialism. What is the definition of socialism? You have to write here. Next, write about the main principles of socialism. So what are the main principles of socialism? Up to now we have discussed. Write about the famous socialist personalities in India. So now only we have discussed so many Indians influenced by socialist ideology, and they formed trade unions also. So you have to write here. Why did women protest against men? Write reasons. What are the reasons for women protest movements? So next, how were women inspired for protest? So this is also another question. Children, try to write answers to these questions and show it to your social studies teacher. Thank you, one and all.